Welcome to St. Andrews Institute of Technology and Management. This college is affiliated to Maharishi Dayanand University, Rohtak, and approved by All India Council for Technical Education. This video lecture is a part of series developed for online classes. Hello everyone, my name is Ashish Tripathi and I am working as an assistant professor at St. Andrews Institute of Technology and Management since 2015. My areas of interest are data analysis and data visualization, which are recommended to be a data scientist. Welcome to Object Technologies and Programming using Java. In this video lecture of Unit 3, we will study about the exception and exception handling. Exception handling: when an error occurs during the execution of a program, then it is called exception. It is an unwanted error that occurs during the runtime of a program and disrupts the normal flow. The process of managing, controlling, and reporting the exception is called the exception handling. Whenever an exception occurs, in an exception object is created and handed over to runtime system. This is called throwing an exception. After throwing an exception, the runtime system finds an appropriate method to handle such exception. This is called catching an exception. Hence, the error handling code has two parts. The first one, to detect the errors and throw exceptions. The second one, to catch the exceptions and take appropriate actions. There are basically two types of exception. One is the built-in exception, the other is the user-defined exception. So you can see that when we are running a program, then sometimes some error occurs. This type of error which is occurring during the runtime of a program is called the exception. So to make our program robust, we should make the proper handling of this exception. This is known as exception handling. First, we need to create an object of the type exception, and then we have to throw that exception. Next, we have to catch the exception thrown and take the appropriate action for it. Exception is an error event that can happen during the execution of a program and disrupt the normal flow. Java provides a robust and object-oriented way to handle exception scenarios known as Java exception handling. Hence, exception handling is the mechanism to handle the runtime malfunctions. The purpose of exception handling mechanism is to provide a method to detect and report an exceptional circumstance so that the right action can be taken. The life cycle of an exception handling is that it starts with finding the problem, which is known as hit the exception. Second step is to inform that an error has occurred. It is called throw the exception. Third step is to receive the exception information, which is called catch the exception. And the fourth step is we should take corrective action, which is called handle the exception. So the life cycle of exception handling begins with hitting the exception, then throwing the exception object, next catching the exception object, and then handling the exception properly with the proper defined functions. Built-in exception. These are already defined in the Java language. These are thrown by Java runtime system to explain the exceptional condition. Some of them are arithmetic exception, array index out of bound exception, class not found exception, file not found exception, null pointer exception, IO exception, and number format exception. user defined exception. These are defined by the user in the application program. The throwing and catching is done by the program only. These new exceptions are inherited by the exception class. So whenever we want to make an exception of our own, then we have to make an instance of the exception class. Here is a close look of the exception which are built in the Java language. The first is arithmetic exception. This is thrown when there is a problem in the arithmetic operation, like number is divided by 0. So whenever we divide a number by 0, then there is an arithmetic exception raised. The next is array index out of bounds exception. This is thrown when an attempt is made to access an array element beyond the index of the array. Likewise, we have an array of size 10. That means it has an index from 0 to 9, and we are accessing the element of the 12th location from this array. It will raise the array index out of bound exception. Third is array store exception. This is thrown when a program tries to store the wrong type of data in an array. Suppose your array is made up of integers and you are storing a float value in it, then you are getting array store exception. Fourth exception is class not found exception. This is thrown when one tries to access a class which is not defined in the Java program. Suppose you are making an object of a class which you haven't defined in the previous section, then you will be getting class not found exception. Next is file not found exception. This is thrown when an attempt is made to access a non-existent file. Suppose you want to open a file for reading or writing and that file is not in the correct location, then you are getting file not found exception. Out of memory exception. This is thrown when memory is accessed to allocate a new object but there is not enough memory. So this is the case when you are out of memory. Suppose you have a 2 MB of memory left and your object is taking 4 MB size, then you are getting out of memory exception. Null pointer exception. This is thrown when an attempt is made to reference a null object. Example, when a method is called on an object which is just declared, not created. Suppose you have declared an object of a class but you haven't used the new keyword. So if you haven't used the new keyword, then the memory is not allocated to the object, hence it is just a reference. When you are using that reference, then you are using the null pointer exception. Number format exception. This is thrown when an attempt is made to perform an invalid conversion of a string to a numeric format. Suppose you want to convert a string into a numeric format. Likewise, you have 57 written, but you have 57 as the string. This 57 cannot be converted into a numeric format. Hence, you will be getting number format exception. String index out of bound exception. This is thrown when an attempt is made to an index outside the bound of a string. As you know that a string class is a finite class in Java. So whenever you are creating an instance of a class in string, then that has the fixed length and it cannot be changed. But if you are accessing the string outside the index location, then you are getting a string index out of bound exception. Interrupted exception. This is thrown when one thread interrupts another thread. So in a multi-threading environment, if you are not synchronizing the thread by using the monitor class, then this interrupt exception is thrown, because when one thread wants to update the value of a shared variable, then the other thread will be interrupting it. IO exception. This is thrown by the general input-output failure, such as inability to read from a file. Suppose you have inserted a pen drive into the computer and that pen drive is not readable, then you are getting the IO exception. Methods involved in exception handling. In Java, the exception handling is done by the following keyword. There are 5 keywords like try, catch, throw, throws, and finally. Here is a diagram to showcase the flow of the exception. There is a try block which has the statement that causes an exception. Then you have a catch block which contains the statement that handles the exception. And at the last, you have the finally block which have the statement that are always executed. So let us begin with the try block. The try block contains the code to monitor for the errors and throw an exception. If an exception occurs, then the remaining statements are skipped and control is transferred to the exception handler. This exception handler can be defined by the programmer or by the Java compiler. Hence, a try block must be followed with at least a catch or a finally block. Next is the catch block. The catch block handles the exception thrown under the try block. There may be more than one catch block for a try block, each handling different types of exception. Exception reference is passed as argument to these catch blocks. Remember, the last catch block should be handling the most general class of exception. Here is an example to showcase the exception handling. We have a class exception demo. Inside it, we have created a function called main and we have declared a block that is a try block. Inside the try block, I have created 3 variables A, B and C of integer type. I have provided value 10 to the A variable and value 0 to the B variable. Then I am performing the calculation A divided by B. Next, I have written the statement which is printing the quotient as C. But you know that whenever I am trying to divide a number by 0, then it will raise an exception, and that is a kind of arithmetic exception. Hence, from the line C equals A divided by B, the control is transferred to the catch statement. Inside the catch statement, there is an argument for the arithmetic exception, which is saying some display option, that is arithmetic exception caught, and the instance variable is being transferred into a string typecast so that it will be displayed on the screen. In this way, we can handle an exception which is generated by the Java compiler. This is a built-in type exception handling. Throw statement. If a method is not able to handle a particular type of exception, then it is thrown from the body either by the compiler or by the method itself using the throw statement. This statement is used to create an instance of the either built-in or the user-defined exception and raise that exception to the runtime handler. So the syntax of this statement is you have to write the throw keyword followed by the exception object. The finally block. This block provides a mechanism to perform the certain task which needs to be done before the closing of the program. Whether or not an exception occurs, it is always executed. It can replace a catch block. There are 2 ways to define the finally statement. First, it can be defined just after the try block. Second, it can be defined just after the last catch block statement. So you can say that finally block will be executed automatically if there is an exception or if there is won't an exception. In both of these cases, the finally is going to be executed. Hence, we can release the resources like closing the file, closing the connection in this finally block. The throws statement. This statement is used to specify the list of exceptions which can be thrown by the following block. It does not raise an exception. Rather, it symbolizes that the block might throw an exception. Hence, the calling of the block must handle that exception. So, it is just bewaring the calling statement that yes, this function or this method might throw an exception if it occurs. Here is an example to showcase the same. We have created a class demo. Inside it, there is a try block which is calling the show function, and it is also catching the arithmetic exception and null pointer exception. Inside the show function, there is a throw statement which is throwing a null pointer exception. Hence, to make it beware, the declaration statement of the show statement has throws null pointer exception as the statement. So when the show function is being executed, it will throw a null pointer exception after displaying exception throw statement, and then the control will be passed to the main function catch block. Here the first catch block is first examined, that is arithmetic exception. So it won't be matched with the null pointer exception object. Hence, we can try some other catch. The second catch is null pointer exception. It is of the same object type. Hence, this will be executed. In this example, the even number exception class is created, which inherits the exception superclass. Then, a constructor of the even num exception class in which there is a super keyword is used is created. First, an array in the main method is declared and initialized. It has the values 2, 4, 6 and 7. Next, whether the array elements are even or not, it will be checked. Then using the if statement, each element of an even number array is checked. So we are just checking it by dividing it by 2. If after division the value of var is 0, then the number is even number, and if it won't, then the number is an odd number. Whenever there is an odd number, then the object of the even num exception constructor is created. Next, the throw clause, which is used when an integer value other than 0 is returned for the array element divided by 2. In the catch block, the even num exception is handled. So for the value 2, it will be printed as an even number. For the value 4, it will be printed as an even number. For the value 6, it will be printed as an even number. But for the value 7, the exception known as even num exception object is created, that is anonymous object, in which the array value and a message called is an odd number is passed. This message is passed to the super class of the even num exception, which is exception class itself, and this will raises an exception. This exception is being handled by the Java runtime system. Question for today's session are: what is exception handling? Describe the life cycle of handling an exception. Explain the keyword try, catch, throw, throws, and finally. What are built-in exception? Create and handle an exception where the user age is less than 0. Thanks for watching this video. In this video, you have learned what are exceptions and how to handle them. You have learned that there are basically two types of exception. One is built-in exception, the other is the user-defined exception. Here, by using the keyword try, catch, throw, throws, and finally, you can properly handle the exception and make your Java class robust.